What is going on, y'all? It's your boy. I pull up to the house, bringing you some impossible challenge gameplay, ultimate team action on NCAA football 14. I wanted to bring you some Heisman gameplay, just to kind of silence those who still don't believe I play on Heisman on any other game mode. But whatever, that's not really the point. I just, I thought I had a good time playing this, so I figured I'd post this for you because this ultimate team was absolutely stacked. Guys like, the legendary Bo Jackson, RG3, Randy Moss, Charles Woodson, Champ Bailey, all those guys. Speaking of Bo Jackson, on the first play of the game, he absolutely trucks like four defenders and then drags some more guys for a 15-yard gain. And let me tell you, playing this is not easy at all. I would never play against this team with my Georgia State team because they probably get rolled because they're 99s everywhere. I mean, the Alabama team I beat was a 99 overall as D. Milliner drops the pick, which kind of pissed me off because you can't give a team like this extra opportunities. But that team that I beat in the NCAA offline dynasty I'm playing is definitely not the same. These guys are Hall of Famers, collegiately, professionally, so on and so forth. And they come to play, man, as Tim Brown goes across the middle for an easy 15-yard reception, setting them up already in our red zone, looking to score early and often on us. And my team isn't as I started my but look at that hit, Winston guy. I suggest going to pick him up, but he's not very expensive either. Strong safety with a 97 tackling. But like I was saying, my team isn't stacked whatsoever. We're not bad. We're like a 92 overall. But I've got I don't have a lot of packs. I get a pack every week from the I get a pack every week from my access to EA Sports Season Pass or whatever. So I get a free All-American pack every week. So I use that and I sell the good guys for extra coins and just go through the auction process and buy good players or whatever. Here, I'm a moron. I went for it on 4th and 5. We have no chance of getting this because their defense is so good. They stop us and they're going to have the ball inside our territory once again. Kind of a moron when it comes to that kind of stuff. But what can you do? It's the CPU and I don't respect them. Even though they are amazing, it's just not the same as playing a user, so I figure I can do whatever I want to. But with this team, this impossible team, it's impossible for a reason. They have talent everywhere. They have good blocking. Even their fullback is a 99. Their William Floyd elite fullback they have is so good. They're facing a third down. We run some contain to make sure RG3 doesn't do that, what he just did, scramble outside and get any yardage. And the negative gain leads to a field goal from Sebastian Janikowski. And we're going to end the first quarter trailing just 3-0. We could be down even more. We're going to run one more play before the end of the first quarter. And we're going to go down the field to Ladarius Green, my 90-speed tight end. I recommend picking him up as well. He's pretty cheap. Looks like we ran some no huddle. 8 seconds left. They leave the middle of the field open. That's why I ran the no huddle offense on them because I liked what I saw. And we're only down 3-0 going into the second quarter. Things are looking good for us, but you just never know. Their defense is stacked. They got Reggie White and Julius Peppers and 99 linebackers, and we're stopped cold on 3rd and 4, looking silly trying to go up the middle on that excellent defense. But me being a noob again, I had to go for it because I'm too proud to just take my 3 points and run. So I get sacked on the blitz, and we get nothing again. This time, at least they weren't, they weren't in our territory. We're going to have an easy chance to score, and it gives our defense an actual chance to make a play like that one right there. Dwight Freeney, who I just picked up, I think he's a 92. I got him for like 1,500. So, my suggestion to you guys – excuse me, would definitely be to search long and far for great players at cheap prices, because some guys may be just desperate to get rid of players they have. As there's is that Michael Irvin? Look at that 54-yard reception, just goes down the field making us look silly, mainly because I was running that contain all defense on RG3, so there was no pass rush and he had all day to throw. And if you give them all day to throw, they're going to break off their routes and leave our defense in the dust and your defense as well. So that was my fault. Whatever. Now they're facing a 3rd and 6. They try to run something to Barry Sanders in the flat, and we're like, nah, we're not going with that. Negative 6-yard gain or whatever. Leads to a 4th and 11, and Sebastian Janikowski, best kicker on this game, probably the best kicker in the NFL right now as well, because his boot is crazy. He kicks like 60-yarders just for breakfast, So what could have been much worse. We're only down 6-0 at the end of the coming to the end of the first half. Vic scrambles out of the pocket. We got just over a minute and a half to play. Finds a wide open Michael Floyd across the middle for 24 yards. So maybe we're getting something going. So I decided to run some more no huddle, keep things going. And And yeah, we're standing in the shotgun because the running game is just, it's futile at this point. There's no point. As we find a wide open Andre Johnson streaking to the end zone for a 43-yard TD. Not sure what Champ Bailey's doing while he's waving the playoff like it was incomplete. It was obviously a completed pass, so I don't know. Maybe collegiate Champ Bailey wasn't as smart as NFL Champ Bailey. Shout out to my Broncos. Let's go. But yeah, now they got the ball back just over just under a minute and a half to play. RG3 throws across the field and throws across his body. Mistakenly throws it right into the hands of Antoine Kaysen, a hated rival of mine since he plays for the San Diego Chargers, but he's very good on this game. This actually isn't his elite card. This is his gold card, an 89-rated cornerback, but makes the pick six nonetheless, giving us a 14-6 lead. Now, just under a minute left to play in the first half, and they're facing a 3rd-and-5. They're desperate to get out of this half because they're making plays left and right. They give it to their workhorse, Bo Jackson, the 99, the untouchable, the unstoppable, but we actually bring them down for, you know, for no gain, forcing them to punt the ball. Now, we have just under 10 seconds left to go in the half. I got sacked or something like that, and I had to run the no huddle in order to get the playoff because I'm out of timeouts, and I hiked the ball, throw it deep to guess who? Andre Johnson once again streaking down the field. I really suggest running some no huddle plays here and there because sometimes you can catch the defense off guard, just like I did on those two touchdowns to Dre Johnson. So let's go. After being down 6-0 and our offense moving nowhere, we're now up 21-6 going into the half. Things are looking excellent. And let's go. Speaking of my team, who do I have? I got a J.J. Watt, 92, some pretty strong defensive linemen, Andre Johnson, DeSean Jackson. Speaking of DeSean Jackson, first play of the second half after a really stupid kickoff return, got us at the 9-yard line. DeSean Jackson goes across the middle, makes a great catch through traffic, and he is gone. 97 in speed, I believe. You're not going to catch him on a route like that. He is out of here, getting a 91-yard touchdown. For good measure, slamming the ball in the end zone. And Vic already has 3 touchdowns on only 9 completions for 300-plus, 28-6. And, yeah, we're making them look absolutely awful right now. Winston, the guys, you see, he's doing his thing at safety. I'm running with my linebacker like I always do. RG3 throws again, and guess who it is? Antoine Kaysen getting another interception. If I didn't hate him so much for being a San Diego Charger, I would give him even more props, but I can't do it just because I'm prideful, and I hope my team wins every AFC West game again this year. So, but that's neither here nor there. Can't wait to make an NFL predictions video because that'll be coming out pretty soon because I'm so pumped about the season. Now, 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. We're just trying to run the clock out now, get this win, get these coins, and get the little, I don't know what it is, a little achievement kind of thing you get for winning an impossible challenge. Going across the field, and Mike Vick puts just enough touch. You know, I'm channeling my inner Omarion right there, no homo. And look at DeSean Jackson, 2 catches for 113 yards. 1 catch was 91 yards, the other was 22, and he's averaged some pretty good yardage. Now, 3rd-and-3, this is the final play of the third quarter, and D'Angelo Williams, who I just got as well, another cheap back you can probably have for about 800 to 1,000 coins. Gets me the first down, setting up a first and goal, giving us a chance to run out some more clock. And going to the fourth, they have a 28-6 lead, so this is all about over. So while you're watching some more of the fourth quarter play out, I wanted to talk about something I plan on doing for you guys since you're such avid sports fans like I am and you love NCAA like I do. What I'm going to do, whether you sub or not, whatever, after watching this video, be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed, of course. What I'm going to do, based on the amount of likes I get, I'm going to do a giveaway. Now, I'm not a rich man. I got a wife, I got kids, and I don't have actual money to just buy shit to give away. You know, it's hard out here. It's a struggle. But what I'm going to do, I don't know, say every 10 likes or so, I want to give back to you guys who love NCAA as much as I do. So, when the time comes and you see the videos hit like 10 likes, 20 likes, etc., hit me up on Xbox Live. Gamertag is the same as my YouTube channel, as I make a great interception with Quentin Carter. Same as my YouTube channel, I pull up to the house, or hit me up on Xbox Live, or hit me up with a YouTube inbox message, whatever, just saying, hey, I saw the video, can I have this? And I'm giving away some gold players. I've been shopping, if you will. I've got like 50,000 coins that I've been selling on my elite cards I get in my weekly packs or whatever. And yeah, just hit me up. Let me know that you want a gold card, and we'll work something out. I mean, I've got tons of players, and I wanted to give back, especially because when I first started playing Ultimate Team my team sucked so bad. They were just terrible. My corners were like all 75 or lower. As you see, we finished off the impossible challenge. It wasn't too impossible for me. Things went really well in the second half. And we win 28-6, got 2,000 coins and that item award, which is just kind of like a collectible. But anyway, like I was saying, just hit me up in one of those avenues, whether it's the YouTube channel or my Xbox Live. If I don't have any friend request spots open, just send me a message, just asking for a player. And yeah, I got tons of players, defensive linemen, offensive linemen, receivers, quarterbacks, running backs, blah, blah, blah. But it's your boy, I pull up to the house. Be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe if you're new, and I'm gone. Peace.